Prophet is not a man of complaint. It's a man of forgiving, kindness, loving, caring. You go to Ta'if, the same Prophet who went there to give light to the people of Ta'if, instead of welcoming the Prophet, they welcome him with the stones. The Prophet was bleeding. Jibreel came down. Ya Rasulallah, what would you want me to do with them? And now you put yourself in the shoes of the Prophet. You come to somebody's house to give them a cake, and then suddenly you get stoned. And then the police come and say, what do you want me to do? Allahu Akbar. Take him to jail, arrest him, right? That's us. Rasulullah, Jibreel asked him, what do you want? He said, Ya Jibreel, I have a dua for them. Rabbi ihdi al-qawm fa'innahum la ya'lamun. Allah, I ask you to guide them. Don't do it. I ask your guidance. That's Rasulullah. Now the same Rasulullah, he is now complaining to Allah about something. It should be something to call our attention. This man was in this situation, doesn't complain. Now, what is it that somebody did to him to make him complain to Allah? That is something to think about. What was it? And who is he complaining about? He's complaining about you and I, about us. To whom? To Allah. What did we do? Now go to the Quran. The Prophet says, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ, Allah is calling him. He said, the messenger said to me, Ya Rabb, O my Lord, إِنَّ قَوْمِي, my people, اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. I brought them the best book you can ever imagine, which is Quran. But what did they do? مَهْجُور. Al-Hijra in Arabic is to leave something for something, or to leave a place from one, to move from one place to another. Meaning, Ya Allah, I brought them the Quran, but they forgot Quran and started to think out to take something other than the Quran. They abandoned the Quran. That is the complaint of the Prophet to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He brought us the best book, but we put it aside and we abandoned it. Now going back to the ayah, the Quran tells us that the Prophet complained that we abandoned the Quran. How did we abandon Quran? Now I want to tell you some kind of group and categories, and then I want you and I to choose and learn which group am I belong to, and then better ourselves as we get into new year tonight. And let us make a new resolution between us and Allah. That Ya Allah, as this new year is coming, I want to be a friend of Quran. How, brothers and sisters? Now, when we say the Quran being abandoned, there are different categories. Now, category number one, you know, some people, some of us Muslims, our relationship with Quran is once a year. And it's only 1 month in a year. And you know that month, right? Ramadhan. Throughout the year, they have nothing to do with the Quran. Quran is there, it's dusty, mashallah, nobody cares about it. Until they hear, oh, two days to Ramadan, mashallah, where's my Quran? Some people didn't have Quran, they go and buy, they borrow it, they come, they dust this, they look at night, mashallah, they read it, they hear it, until the night before Eid. When they hear tomorrow is Eid, alhamdulillah, they close Quran, sadaqallahu al-azim, Khuda Hafiz, if I leave next year, I'll see you. If not, bye-bye. Quran has been placed back. Nothing to do with the Quran anymore. Their relationship with the Quran is just once a year, and that is during the month of Ramadan. That's it. That is one form of abandoning of the Quran. That is number one. Number two, some of us know we only read Quran when somebody passed away. Somebody died in the family, 24 hours, Abdul Basit is going up and down. You enter the house, Abdul Basit. You get out, Abdul Basit. Masha Allah. Why? Because somebody passed away. We have to listen to the Quran. It's like Allah sent the Quran for the deceased. If everybody's fine, nobody died, no, we're not going to listen to the Quran. Until somebody is dead, Masha Allah, Quran is going up and down every single day, mashallah. Till the 40 or 40 of that mayyit, Quran is on. After 40, no more Quran. Forget about it. That is another form of abandoning of Quran. Allah didn't send Quran for the deceased. Allah sent the Quran for the living people. That is why Imam Ali said, اقرأوا القرآن قبل أن تقرأ عليكم. Read Quran before they read it on your ruh. You yourself open it, read it for yourself. Why do you have to wait until somebody come to read after you and I pass away? That is number two. Number three, some mu'mineen, how do they abandon Quran? They abandon Quran that all they do is when they buy a new house. Right? MashaAllah, come on. We read Surah Yasin, Hadith al-Kisa. Because we have a new house. Okay, it's good. It's not haram. It's good thing to buy a new house and read Quran in the house. But the Quran was not revealed for just to open houses. Quran was revealed for more than that. Why is it that until I buy a new house, then I remember, yes, we have to read Quran so we can get the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After we finish, mashallah, that's it. We have nothing to do with the Quran anymore. That is another form of mahjur, abandoning of the Quran that the Prophet is talking about. That's number three. Number four, some mu'mineen know. How do they abandon Quran? All they do with the Quran is they only try to memorize it. MashaAllah, every page you ask them, MashaAllah, it's all there, computerized, right? MashaAllah, you ask them every surah, they know by heart. Allahu Akbar. But just look the way they dress. Do they dress like the way Quran wants? When they see them outside, do they leave Quran? Or they leave different life? Completely opposite of the life of Quran. So their way of abandoning Quran is that they memorize it, but Quran has nothing to do with anything in their life. That is another form of abandoning Quran, because Quran didn't come just memorized. No, there's more to it than to memorize it. That is category number four. Number five, some people don't, they emphasize about Quran in terms of recitation. MashaAllah, beautiful voice. Good. When they open their mouth, Allahu Akbar. Beautiful voice, beautiful recitation. They concern about tajweed. Every single rule that is mentioned in tajweed. Idgham, ikhfa, iqlab, idhar, mada, asha, tajdi. Everything you can think of. They make sure that they recite it properly. But is there anything more than that? No. That is another form of abandoning Quran. All these forms, the Prophet is complaining to us, to Allah, that we, his ummah, he brought us this Quran, but this is how we divided the Quran. Some of us, we take the Quran just at this time, some people this, and we abandon the message of Quran. Now, what is it, brothers and sisters, about the Quran? What is the best way to deal with the Quran? The memorization is good in Islam. Opening the house with the Quran is a good thing. All of this is good. But there is more to it. How? Quran is good to read. It's good to open the house with it. But more to it is to live Quran as a Muslim. Let the Quran be your constitution. That is what the Quran is about.